Welcome to Srpske Pleso, where a little bit of history will be made at the 2015 Universiad. Women's ski jumping, a relatively new discipline, and for the first time today, there will be a women's team competition for the women. Stay with us to see if Russia can continue their domination of the Universiad. It's about 2 degrees minus 0, and they're the Russian fans and team hoping that their team will get another gold. They're the big, big favourites. There are 5 teams here. One is a mixed team made up of Svetlana Gladykova and Katarina Kahl. There's the Chinese of Tong Ma and Xiaoyu Li. Czech Republic, Vladina Puskova and Mikhaila Dolazalova. Japan, Aki Matsuhashi and Yuka Kobayashi. And the big, big favourites are Russia, Anastasia Gladysheva and Irina Avakumova. So in the first round is Aki Matsuhashi. She was a 6th place in the individual competition, 172.4 points. Expected to be silver medalists here. Didn't surprise a few people as Matsuhashi. And that's a better than expected jump. Good work. It's well over 80 meters, close to 85, 84, yeah. And that surely will at least tie up a silver. Might put a bit of pressure on the Russians as well. Jump from the Japanese there, and the star mark's not bad either. 96.2 the total is the big star of this competition, Irina Avakumova, former Russian national champion. 6th in the overall World Cup standings, and she needs a big jump, but she's got one just short of 90, and that'll put Russia back ahead. And they need Avakumova to be in form in Slovakia. The winner of the individual competition a couple of days ago, quite easily as well. And that's why Russia are the big, big favourites here. It's going to be 94.7 points. 107 in total. And that puts Russia ahead at the halfway mark. There you have it, 13 points. That's a decent cushion. Most people would have expected to be a bit more. Czech Republic should be okay for a bronze. So we'll get ready for the second round of competition now. Each of the jumpers will go again. Here's Anastasia Gladysheva from Nizhny Novgorod. 24.5 in the first jump for her. Gladysheva, the bronze medalist in the individual competition a few days ago. There's Gladysheva. She's well short of 90. And she's disappointed with that, 84.5. Maybe the Japanese will be in with a shout. Only 75 meters. And that's disappointment for Russia. And a surprise could be on the cards, 174.8. The total. Dolazalova and the Czech Republic should be okay for a bronze. Silver medalist in the individual 2 years ago. If she doesn't make any mistakes, she'll be going home with the bronze, and that should be enough. Dolazalova and Vladina Puskova, Czech Republic, at least a bronze, and they'll be happy with that against two very strong teams, Japan and Russia. Avakumova, the pressure is on, because Russia are not leading ahead of the final jump, which is sensational, really. But that's a sensational jump. Avakumova, that's 90 meters. And that'll put real pressure on Kobayashi, who's still to go. Brilliantly done, good star marks as well. The V shape there, good aerodynamics. And just when Russia needed Avakumova, she's come up with a brilliant leap. 18 from each of the judges. So it's still in the Japanese hands. They can still win it, but Kobayashi needs a big leap of about 86 meters. It would be a sensation if Russia are denied. The huge favorites, but Japan can still do it. Can Kobayashi get there? She looks a little bit short. We'll wait for the judges' marks, but I think she's about a meter short. Heartbreak for them. Indeed, it's not quite enough, 192.2. It's been a fine performance, you know, from Japan, but it's Russia's gold, and Irina Avakumova taking the plaudits. They have the gold, Kobayashi and the Matsuhashi, a creditable silver, Czech Republic third.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.